Okay, guys, we're at the campground.
So I'll get set up here. Yeah, guys, we're at Crosswinds Campground on Jordan Lake, right there. So, beautiful lake.
We have some beautiful fishing. But we are going to have to unpack this whole float boat, unfortunately, because I think it's all packed on top of the boat. Let's get to it. Grab our cooler out. Hot in there today. Probably gonna need to add some more ice to this. Probably not till tomorrow. But as you can see, everything is packed in. The camping gear is all the way packed in. Yeah. I don't like that part of it. But see what we can do here to get ourselves around. Lay it down by the car, but set it right there for now. There's no way. I say there's no way we can get it through the forest. I really don't know. I'm not done it. I don't know. We'll give it a try. Let's see what happens here. But first things first. Get all of this out. Get set up. Probably don't need our shade here right now. But we definitely need this. So the other thing. See if we do. Look at this, guys. 6x8 should be perfect. Unused 6x8. I might need that tarp for the top of this. Really, probably not. There's no tarp on it, but oh wait. Yep, we got a rain fly. Forgot we brought that big, huge rain fly. I don't know though about. Oh yes, that's what I needed. This one will not go up. I've only set this tent up once, so we'll see how this goes. Why I pulled it in upside down. our stakes going. Pull our four corners and stake our four corners and work out from there. Get everything staked in. I don't think this one's going to take too long to set up though. Rain fly, but I don't know why it would need a rain fly. I mean, I guess heavy rain, but it's not like it's a mesh top to begin with.
These two, I don't want to stake them together. They'll end up right in my way. This is the rain fly. There's no rain fly. Yeah, there's a rain fly. I don't know what the heck that is. It's got a little clip. It's supposed to be a rain fly. Oh. Two more stakes to put out. I'm sweating up a storm, guys. Sweating a storm up. Pull this out. This is going to allow wind. I already put it better, especially
The only thing about the adventure vehicle, rain does get in.
No rain does get in.
Okay, we're gonna figure it out. I think I'm just gonna use. Suck for us if we can't get a bed blown up. Let's get this off if we can. We can wiggle this off. It was hot when I put it on. I got it. Put that right in there. And we can blow this bed off. So. I don't really know where I want to blow it up. I want to blow it up, I think, out of here. So it's the same way we're going to blow up the tube as well. If we do blow both, it'll be just like this. We are getting our workout for this afternoon. Okay. Got some water stuff on it. Hopefully we can get that dried out before we go to sleep. It is just on the edges. In one of those foot pumps, but this thing takes up such a small amount of space. Just don't know about getting one of the big boat foot pedals. That certainly would be easier and fill it faster. But if I brought my compressor with me, this would be easy peasy. Thank you. Okay, so that's done. Get this up. Back in here. This. Back in here. Okay. I'll probably just throw all of this. Thank you. Yeah. ones that came with it are nice. But as nice as they are, they're just in case. These are literally just in case. We want you to have a boat we're on. We want you to have a power. That's gonna work good though. I got these stoppers. These rubber rings are gonna keep water. Probably a little bit of trouble. It makes notice me putting these rubber rings on now. I don't put them on right now. If they close, and then I'll quit. Once this, all the way in. Stuck on the plastic. It's about 2 inches at the end. There's a piece of plastic. I'll start to zip this. This bag obviously was not made for this boat.